I'd like to call this meeting to order. Clerk of the Board, would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Carter?
Here.
Freeholder Estrada?
Estrada's present.
Freeholder Hudak?
Here.
Freeholder Jallo?
Here.
Freeholder Kowalski? Freeholder Mirabella? Freeholder Wright?
Here.
Vice Chairman Granados?
Here.
And Chairman Bergen?
Here.
Chairman, you have 7 freeholders present.
Thank you. Clerk of the Board, would you please lead us in the prayer and salute to the flag?
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and the lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace.
Amen.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk of the Board, please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act.
The Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey statutes annotated Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2017, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2017 in the Administration Building, and further, by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2017 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. We have communications, which we will approve at our regular meeting, which is on July 20th. We have a number of proposed resolutions. First, we have from the Office of the Union County Prosecutor. With us is First Assistant Prosecutor Tim Eisenhower.
This is what happens when you don't have a meeting in 3 weeks. We're all over the place.
The prosecutor's office has 2 resolutions on for your consideration. I'll be happy to take any questions you may have.
Thank you. Freeholders, yes. Freeholder Carter.
Can you go into number one a little bit? What is it? It says expansion and upgrade. So what do we currently have?
Basically, this is for the Child Advocacy Center interrogation rooms or interview rooms, if you prefer. Right now, they're already outfitted with some equipment. It's very old equipment. The state offered a grant to all the counties for either the creation of new child advocacy centers, or if you had an existing child advocacy center, as Union County does, we were allowed to use it to make capital improvements. And one of the things, a lot was more furniture, carpeting, those type of more capital type expenditures. But for this particular expenditure, it's an upgrade to the camera system and the servers we use to store any videotaped interviews we take. They could be videotaped interviews of children, they could be witnesses, or they could be suspects. Because of the necessity of maintaining those, the cost is a little higher than I would like. A lot of this has to do with the installation of new cameras, new equipment, soundproofing, the rooms that we use. It's really just a overall upgrade. I shouldn't even call it an upgrade. It's basically a brand new system, audio-visual system to record all sorts of interviews that take place, and a storage system to go with it.
So this is a grant?
Completely grant funded.
It's okay. And is there matching funds?
I'll have to check and get back with you on that.
Okay.
I can't remember whether there was a match required for this.
Okay. Thank you.
Chairman, through you, being told no match required.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, County Manager. Any other freeholders? Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good evening.
Office of the Union County Sheriff, Sheriff Crime.
Good evening, Freeholders, County Manager. Thank you for your consideration. We simply ask to extend our agreement with our vet on care of our canines. It's originally $7,000. With this $18,000, it would bring it to $25,000, which is less of a cost than last year, but certainly in line with previous year costs overall.
Thank you. Any questions, Freeholders? Seeing none, thank you, Sheriff.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Administrative Services, Director Yuska.
Good evening, Freeholders. The department has 1 resolution for your consideration. I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Freeholder Estrada.
Hey,
Good evening, sir. How much was it last year, the same amount, or?
If there is a little difference in this, if you'll notice, it's only for 5 months because we want to get it into the budget year. So to fully answer your question, it was $136,000 last year, and this is it would be this for 5 months would be the exactly same thing, and it has been $136,000 for the past 4 years, I believe, to supply this vital service.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Thank you, Director. Department of Economic Development, Deputy County Manager A.B. Wagner.
Good evening. The Department of Economic Development has 8 resolutions for your consideration, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Thank you. Freeholders, any questions? Yes, Freeholder Carter.
Can you just go into a couple of number 5 and number 6, please?
Absolutely. Number 5 is a requirement for anyone that is receiving public assistance. They're required to do job training activities. So that's what these organizations will be providing those activities. Typically, we have about 900 people that enroll in some program over the course of any given year. Number 6, at the last meeting, you voted to award the contract for the American Job Centers, what were once known as the One Stops. This is the funding portion of that resolution. We only got our notification of what our award would be on the 30th of June for the fiscal year that started July 1st. Okay. So that's why we couldn't put funding, because we weren't sure exactly, you know, where that money would be coming
okay.
from.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, Freeholder Estrada.
Yes, I know that was number 6 you were talking about. Is that less than last year, or is it about the same? This is 3.120.
This is actually brand new, because this was the first year that we had to actually go out to bid for the one-stop services. So we've never had to actually award a contract for these services. It's something that we handled internally.
All right, so this is the contract that we have signed with the Department of Human Services.
Correct.
For total, so the allocation for this particular operation is 3.1 million. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Vice Chairman.
Thank you, Chairman. Can you just elaborate on the Project Search program, please?
Absolutely. That is a program that takes place at Overlook Hospital. They take students that are enrolled with Union County Ed Services, and they do classroom work in the morning at Overlook, and then they do internships in the afternoon. There were 9 students that completed the program last year. Freeholder Wright joined me for the graduation ceremony that was really pretty amazing. And as of the day of the graduation, all 9 students had gotten full-time employment. So it's a terrific program, and the kids are really invested, and all the partners are, and they really do learn a lot of important life skills. The funds that we're voting on this evening will help to teach them about travel training, because they have to get to school. There's only one student from last year who was in a wheelchair who had to have separate transportation, but the others are all taking mass transit, which is an incredible life skill beyond just what they do in the classroom.
Sounds good, thank you. Thanks, Chair.
Thank you. Anybody else? Thank you.
Thank you.
Department of Engineering, Public Works, and Facilities Management, Director Graziano.
Good evening, Chairman, Freeholders. The department has 7 resolutions on tonight for your consideration. I'll try and answer any questions you have.
Thank you, Director. Freeholders, any questions? Yes. Freeholder Card.
Can you go into number 3 a little bit? It deals with the Netherwood Avenue Bridge.
Sure. The job went out to bid. It was awarded to Rencor, $2.184 million. $1 million of that is funded through the local bridge and future needs program. We should get going on that bridge sometime in September. September 1st, I'm looking at to get that started. And it's probably a 10-month to 12-month project.
Okay. So have there's like 2 houses. No, 2 houses that are actually on the Plainfield side that would be affected truly by this. Have those owners been notified, and is any of their property being taken or with that, because I know that you've had those phone calls from the owner, one of the owners.
Right.
So I'm just trying to make sure that I'm clear about this, because now we're down to the nuts of this.
I don't know off the top of my head if any properties were taken, but if they were.
Not worth taking. Is it the fact that, you know, through
the easements, right? And,
right.
And an easement there. So if we had to take an easement from their properties, we would have gotten it through them, and they would have been all involved with it. I don't know off the top of my head. I can get that information for you. I don't know if Tom knows. Tom, is there an easement? We did. Okay. All right. Yeah, so we did obtain easements from the Plainfield properties to access
the owners,
easements.
Right. So the owners are fully aware
100%.
And on board. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Freeholder Estrada.
Yes. Graziano, number four on the gel cooling tower project.
Yes.
Now, that's some other words, it was reduced by almost $30,000.
That's correct.
Now, is that all complete now? The whole project is done?
Which whole project? The cooling tower project is, yes.
The tower is, but not the elevators. Is
no,
that?
No, that's a whole separate project. That was a roof and elevator project. That's a couple months out yet.
That's still out?
Yes.
Has not been completed. Okay.
No,
how is that going?
It's good. No, it's I'm still like 2 months out on that project.
2 months out.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any other questions?
Thank you, Director.
Thank you, Chairman.
Department of Finance, Director Taylor.
Good evening, Chairman and members of the board. The Department of Finance has 15 resolutions for your consideration this evening, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you, Director. Any questions from the board? You'll be prepared for Mr. Patterson's question.
Absolutely.
Next week. Thank you, Director. Department of Human Services, Deputy Director.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman and members of the board. The Department of Human Services has 9 resolutions on for your consideration, and I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Any questions from the board? Thank you.
Thank you.
Department of Public Safety, Director Moran.
Good evening, Chair. Members of the board, Department of Public Safety has 5 resolutions for your consideration. I'll try to answer any questions you may have.
Thank you. Any questions from the board? Freeholder Estrada.
Thank you. Mr. Moran, Director Moran, on the issue of that Navistar unit, is that the one going to Elizabeth?
That's correct.
Okay.
We have one resolution declaring it surplus.
Surplus, and the other one to give it away. Is that a working unit?
It had
some issues with the generator and all that other stuff, right?
We did. The generator needs to be replaced on it. There were some electrical issues with it. And in February, we received our new command post that will replace it.
Is Elizabeth aware of all the issues associated with it?
Yes, they are.
I don't want somebody to call back and say, hey, you're giving us a dud here.
Yes, through you, Chairman, yes, there are a number of significant repairs that need to happen on that vehicle, and Director has communicated that to Police Director.
Appreciate it very much. Therefore,
we got you covered.
You know what happens.
Absolutely.
We got you covered.
Any other questions?
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Office of the County Council, Council Barry.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Office of the County Council has 3 items on tonight's agenda, and I would be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Any questions from the freeholders? Seeing none, thank you.
You're welcome.
We have one from the Office of the County Manager.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman. The Office of County Manager has 1 resolution for your consideration, and I'll attempt to answer any questions you may have.
Any questions from the freeholders? Seeing none, thank you. We get to freeholder-sponsored resolutions. Are there any additional resolutions or any friendly amendments requested at this time? Yes, Freeholder Jallo.
Yeah, that might be added to number 5.
Anyone else?
Chairman.
Yes.
Number 5, please, also, if we go to the shot, is okay with it. And then also,
the more than merrier.
I'm sorry, what was
that? And I have an extra one also for next one.
You'll have an extra, okay. Freeholder Hudak.
Number 5 as well, and if I could, I may have another laudatory before
Very
next
good.
Week.
Anyone else? Okay, I'm
Can
going to.
Can we just do number 5 from the
Can
board?
Can we include the whole board for number 5?
Come on, Batman. Come on.
Okay. Did you catch that, Mr. Clerk? Number five will be from the board. Number nine, I'm going to ask to please be added to.
Chairman.
Yes, Vice Chairman.
And as a result, tonight's Freeholder Standing Committee to Open Space, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Trust Fund, I'll have two items to be placed on tonight's agenda for next week.
Thank you. And as the fiscal chairman, Freeholder Mirabella, is not here, on his behalf, there will be a number of sponsorship resolutions coming out of fiscal as well for next week. Anyone else? Yes, Freeholder Carter.
Can I be added to number eight also, please?
Check it out here for you.
Thank you. Anything further? Seeing none, may I please have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you all.